I'm Hilary and welcome to Adept English. This is day one of our 7-day course, The 7 Rules of Adept English. Thank you for joining me. Every day for 7 days you will receive an email with a link to a video like this one attached to it, an MP3 file just of the audio, just of my voice, and a PDF file so that you've got a written version, a written transcript of what I'm saying. Now, we're going to be introducing you to a different way of learning English language. Different rules, a different way of learning, not what you've necessarily come across before. Now, the first thing to say is this course is not aimed at beginners. If you can understand what I'm saying to you, or most of it, in this video, you should be fine. You are at the right level. If it's really difficult for you to understand, even with the transcript, it's probably better to do a basic course first and then come back to us later. This course is aimed at improving fluency. That's specifically what Adept English enables you to do. Now, the reason why I've developed this course is because it's a very common experience for people to learn the basics of a language, learn the vocabulary and learn the grammar and have a working knowledge of a language. That's very different from fluency. Now, Adept English aims to help you become fluent at English. You may have had the experience where you can understand what's being said on your language course, but then when you're faced with native English speakers and the way they talk, actually it's really hard to understand. There's a phrase in English, rabbit in the headlights, and what we mean by that, when a rabbit is caught in the headlights of a car, it's sort of frozen, it doesn't know what to do. And I think this describes the experience when you're speaking a foreign language and you construct some sentences and you're speaking with a native speaker. So you say your piece and then they come back at you with lots and lots of language and it's really fast and it's really fluent. And you're like this because you don't understand it and you don't know what to respond with. Now, this is because there's a big difference between the learning the mechanics of a language, learning the common words, learning the irregular verbs, and being able to have a conversation naturally that's fluid and do that without great effort. Now, there are many, many people in the world who automatically learn English as their second language. Tends to be what's taught in school, and if not there, you may have learnt it in college. But it's very common to get stuck before you learn fluency. And sometimes people give up or their language stays frozen in this state for many, many years. Now, the problem is not so much with the students themselves, but it's with the teaching method. And teaching methods often make it very mechanical. This isn't how language learning happens for people in their native language. I'm guessing that you're very fluent in your own language, that you feel utterly confident and competent to speak it, and that you do it really without thinking about it at all. Now, how did this happen? Well, of course, like anybody else, it began to happen when you were very small, when you were still a baby, in fact. Every day you heard spoken around you your native language, and you heard it and you listened, and initially a lot of it you didn't understand, and then bit by bit you began to understand it. This is the natural route to learning a language. If you observe any child, this is the way that they learn. Later on, they learn to read and spell and write. But the first thing always that they do is begin to understand. Understanding always comes before speaking, so small children will understand a great deal more than they can express. Similar with learning a language. So the first rule of Adept English is understand spoken English first. So focus on this and your brain will do the rest. The speaking of it will be a much shorter step if you can improve your understanding. Don't worry so much initially about speaking and writing. You've probably got a reasonably good idea of how to spell the words from your basic language course. The understanding is really the thing to focus on. And the reason why we include a transcript is that you can check the words and phrases that you don't know. So it might be when you read the transcript of what I'm saying to you now, the words and phrases that you didn't understand when you heard them make absolute sense when you see them written down. It may be that even when you see it written down, there are some parts of what I'm saying that you don't understand, but you've got opportunity to check them in the dictionary. Now, what's really important is that you listen again once you've understood, because that helps anchor the word in your mind. Now, rules of grammar and vocabulary are also learned automatically. That saves a lot of pain and a lot of trouble. If you think about a child in English who might say, "I buyed an ice cream," eventually they move to saying, "I bought an ice cream," because they've heard often enough that this is the proper way to say it. Similarly, they might say, "I go to the shop," but eventually they hear it enough times that they begin to say, "I went to the shop." What they don't do is learn lists of irregular verbs. Human brains have been learning language in this way for thousands of years. Why would we make our brains learn language in any other way? All the neural networks are there, ready and waiting to be used. Adept English is not limited to this rule alone. There are six other rules, but this first rule underpins everything else. So understanding first and achieving your understanding by doing lots and lots of listening to spoken language. Now, Adept English aims to provide you with all sorts of subjects, contexts, and give it to you in a convenient and portable format. So initially you might be curious to see who I am and what I look like and to look at the video, but I would imagine pretty soon that won't be necessary. And I expect the way that you may use this is to download the MP3 files, which are fairly small, onto a mobile device and listen to my spoken English that way. I'll give you an example from my personal experience of why I believe this method works. When I went to university and did my first degree, I studied Latin. So I learned all about the Romans, their art, their architecture, their history, their politics, their literature, and of course Latin language. Now, crucially, Latin is a dead language. It was spoken by the Romans centuries ago, but we don't know how it was pronounced. It isn't spoken anywhere in the world now. So a dead language because we don't really know how to say things, and we focused a lot on written Latin. Latin's complicated, and the challenge was that it's good exercise for the brain. So we would translate from English into Latin and Latin into English. So lots of written down Latin, absolutely zero Latin conversation. Fair enough, it's a dead language. Now, at school, I also learned French and German. Now, when I think back to my French lessons, we studied it in much the same way. We did a lot of written down French. We learned a lot of vocabulary. We learned the rules of grammar. We learned to spell French words. We learned how the language worked. We did a lot of boring textbooks. occasionally, tacked on at the end of the lesson, there'd be a bit of French conversation, but probably not very much. How often did we hear French spoken by genuine French speakers? The only time I remember this happening at all was in the exam. If we were doing a comprehension or a dictation, we might then, but it was very rare. The lessons were conducted in English. So what happened for me is that at the end of the course, I had largely a written exam, passed some exams. I passed, I did very well, I got a good grade. That was good for my school. Was it good for me? I'm not sure that it was that great. It gave me the basics of French, but did it mean that I could go to France and have conversation with French speakers? No, it certainly didn't. What happened to me at school as well, though, I learned German, and my experience in German was completely different. For a start, the whole lesson was conducted in German, from start to finish, right from the very first lesson, even though we didn't understand to begin with, but we did learn very quickly. So there was that element, and also I went on to German exchanges. So I went to stay with two German families, each over a period of about 10 days, something like that. And I found that the combination of the German language classes being spoken entirely in German and of visiting Germany and living with a German family, this meant I was immersed in the language and it increased my skill immensely. So German became a living language for me. Now, most adults who might want to learn English don't have the opportunity to go on a language exchange and live with a family for 10 days. They perhaps don't even have the chance to go on a language course. And even if they do, it's probably not going to be one where only the language you're learning is spoken in the classroom, nothing else. Now, Adept English aims to help you make these conditions for yourself. So it aims to help you, supports you to learn English in small sections of your ordinary day, so that your understanding of English is vastly improved. So, to sum up, rule one involves understanding, first of all. Focus on this by doing lots of listening to spoken English by real native speakers. This will have the effect of improving your fluency. That's probably enough for day one. Thank you for listening to me, and I look forward to seeing you tomorrow. Have a lovely day.